What's up, guys? Check it out, we finally got a fairly nice day of good weather. So for this video, we're back outside. Now for the last couple of months, my comment section has been blowing up with people asking me to do something with fidget spinners, make my own fidget spinners, modify fidget spinners. So I've been gearing up to do that. However, on yesterday's video, the most popular comment was from Joe Dion, who said, "Can you please not do anything fidget spinner? I find they're overdone and they would ruin you." And apparently this has become the most popular comment, so I'm switching strategies. In this video, rather than making fidget spinners, I'll be destroying them. Now, a couple of months ago when I realized that fidget spinners were a thing, I reached out to a few different companies to get some prototype samples and brand them King of Random style. The problem is, not all fidget spinners are created equal, and I went through bucket loads of samples trying to find some that I liked. And after months of going back and forth, these are the only two that I settled on because they're both made of metal and I like the way they look. I also noticed the spinners that only have two sides seem to wobble when you turn them back and forth, which is no good. And a lot of spinners seem to have problems with their bearings. They just don't work the way they should. So I finally got a product here that I'm proud of and ready to sell, but I feel like I'm a little late to the game. However, I will put a link down in the description if you want to get the King of Random branded spinners. Not sure how long they'll be here, because the purpose of this video really is to take all the extra samples, fire up the metal foundry, and see what happens when we melt them all together. Now for this experiment, I'm going back to this backyard metal foundry we made with the KO wool, and I've got various size crucibles here, and I don't think we're going to need this huge one, so I'm just going to use this middle size one here. You remember how this works, we're going to just stick a couple of gas jets in from the side, fire it up, let it get nice and hot, and then we'll start adding our fidgets one by one. Yeah! Good. That is awesome. Now looking at these spinners, most of them seem to be made of aluminum, some of them are made of brass, but in either case I'm going to be using this roach away as a flux. It's just 100% boric acid and that's going to help the metal melt down a little bit quicker and keep it a little bit cleaner. Alright, our foundry is heated up and it's ready for melting. I think I'm going to start the melting off with this spinner here. I call this my ninja spinner because it looks like a little throwing star. This thing's made of aluminum, you can see that because I've shaved down the side here, and I think the whole thing is aluminum except for the steel bearings on the inside. Let's go ahead and toss it in. That's toasty. Here we go. That's gotta be getting pretty toasty. That's holding up pretty good so far. Look at the tip of the spinner right here. You can see that's starting to melt. Oh, wow. I'm gonna give it a little stir. Oh, it's gone, look at that. Fidget spinner has become a blob of molten metal. So the first one's taken down, here comes fidget spinner number two. Here we go, 3, 2, 1. Oh yeah, that's the money shot. Woo, doggy! Oh, ouch! Oh my gosh, that just exploded all over my face. I think the battery in those LEDs just exploded and went all over my shirt, my skin, and the camera. Dude, your lens, check it out. That right there is why we wear safety glasses. Molten. Cool. Yeah, roach killer.
It's good stuff. Check it out.
So update guys, our aluminum spinners are gone. They're all completely liquefied. So we're moving up to brass. Oh dude, look at the colors. What the crazy heck is going on? We got like teal blue flame shooting out the top here. Oh Oh my gosh, and the metal is boiling. It's bubbling, it's boiling. It looks absolutely insane. We gotta get this lid off and take a look. All right, check this out. Whoa! Wow! I'm pretty sure that that's the zinc burning off right now. Let's throw a little bit of our roach killer in there to suppress the oxygen. Whew, there we go, see? Roach killer to the rescue. And that's what our flux does, is it helps prevent the oxygen from getting down there and burning off the zinc. So who knew? You burn a brass fidget spinner and you get teal blue flames and a bright yellow explosion. Glad nobody got hurt. We got our trusty mini metal muffin tray and we're gonna gear up for the pour now as soon as I can cool down these gloves. Smoking. Beautiful. All right, I can't even see where the pour spout is on this thing. So I guess it doesn't matter. Check out down there, look at that crucible. You can see it's still so hot that the zinc is burning off. Toasty! Clean crucible is a happy crucible. Quick update guys, we made the pour, it was successful, and we ended up with 5 fidget spinner ingots. Now we're just gonna let those cool down for a minute, then knock them out of the tray and quench them in water, and then set them on a shelf where we can use them for some future project. They look perfect. All right, I'm gonna just flip this thing over, give it a little bang on the ground. Oh, that's what I was afraid of. They're actually so hot that they're melding with the steel in the muffin tray, which means they're gonna be really difficult to get out. And we did it. Oh, you can see some of the crystal structure left over on the inside. That looks really cool. So we successfully did it, guys. We took all of our rejected samples and melted them down together, and this is the alloy that we've created. It's some kind of aluminum brass alloy. I'm not sure what ratios, but it does look very brittle, similar to the stuff that we tried in a previous experiment. Now, what I'm actually gonna end up doing with these, I have no idea. They'll probably just sit on the shelf until I can think of some purpose for them in a future experiment. But apparently that's what happens when you melt down and mix together metal fidgets. And of course, if you still want to jump on the craze and get yourself a metal fidget, I've got a link down in the description to these King of Random brand. These ones are metal, they spin really, really nicely, and out of all the samples that I tested, these are the only ones that I really like. And they come with these cool little zip together cases, which I think are pretty neat and I haven't seen anybody do before. So if you want one of these bad boys, just click the link in the description. That'll take you to where you can find one of these metal fidget ninjas, or the classic version as well, as long as I've still got them available. And as for these, well, I've got 4 boys of my own, so I think I'm just gonna pass these on and see what kind of havoc they can cause at school. And of course, a big shout out to Joe Dion for leaving a comment and getting the popular vote. Go ahead and check your YouTube inbox, Joe. I'm sending you 25 bucks. Well, that's it for this experiment, guys. You now know what happens when you throw metal fidget spinners into a backyard metal foundry. Thanks for joining me for this video, and I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. 3, 2, 1. Oh, I missed. We've invented a new element, randinium.